What are polymers? Polymers are made up of many small molecules joined together to form long chain structures. And then why do we eat poly tulsi leaves if we can digest it? Ma, cellulose means the paper is not made from tulsi plant. Okay. Yes. Understood. This question is also correct. Okay, the paper is made up of cellulose. Like we'll select like jute or somewhat, we'll select the papers which contains high percentage of cellulose. I can't say that all the plants consist of similar kind of cellulose. We all are human beings. Am I right? We are all are human beings. As our digestive system is same.
Yes, Mama, digestive system is kind of same, but it kind of like differs.
I'm not asking our digestive system is same, but how much you can digest? Okay, for example, I can digest more. Okay, you can't able to digest much more. That's if we'll get the same quantity of food or same quantity of things.
About digestion, it depends on like the person.
That's what I'm saying. The same way the cellulose contents in the plants varies from plant to plant. Okay, the selected plant is used for the preparation of paper, which contains high percentage of cellulose present in it. Though our system is similar, but the capability of the digestive system from person to person is different. That is the thing I want to explain. Understood, Veda? Very, very good question, Veda. And Ronak and everyone, Arya, everyone. Okay. So here, polymers are made up of many small molecules joined together to form long chains. Here, polymers are nothing but polymers an atom. No, polymer is not an atom. That monomer consists of a group of atoms. Okay, let me explain. Poly means what? Many. Merge means a part or a segment. Part or a segment. So why I have given this beads neck set or beads pearl set? Why I have given? For the decorative purpose I have given it.
No, ma'am. No. Ma'am, maybe you have given it as an example.
Yes, okay. This has given as an example. Why? Because I can consider each bead over here. Yes, each bead over here, a single bead is nothing but a monomer. A single bead is nothing but a monomer. A group of monomers connected chemically. Here one monomer is connected to another monomer by chemical means. So that a group of monomers in a long chain is known as polymers.
I have a doubt.
Yes, Akshay.
Are substances like pearls made of polymers?
No, pearls are not made up of polymers. This is just an example. That's what I want to say. This is an example to imagine that how polymers are present. If we take the fiber thread, within that fiber thread, we can't zoom it or magnify the fiber thread so that we can see the monomers. We can't see. Understood, children? Understood. Yes. Pearls are not made up of polymers. This is just an example to, like, what I can say by showing that I can explain you the monomers, how they are joined chemically to form a long chain.
Basically, polymers are only present in fibers, right?
Yeah. Not only polymers. Polymers itself consists of many monomers. Okay, monomers are the combination of different kinds of elements or atoms in it. Understood, Akshay? Understood?
Yes, ma'am, understood.
Very good, Akshay.
Ma'am, sometimes, for like those beads, ma'am, sometimes they also put a string between them.
Sometimes also?
They put like a string in between them.
That string is nothing but I'm saying, yeah. Each bead is considered as monomer. One monomer is here. So I want to join the other monomer to form a long chain like polymer. So both how they can join, they need to join chemically, not with the string or anything else.
But ma'am, sometimes they do that.
Here the string acts like a chemical bonding between each monomer.
Yes, ma'am.
Understood? Yes or no? So this process is known as polymerization. What is this process known as?
Polymerization.
So for example, is it visible? So for example, polymer. What do you mean by polymer? Poly means many. Mers means monomers. So if I want to take a pearl beads, a long chain of pearl beads, understood? In that you can't find the string over there because they are very closely arranged. I want to show you, like in brief, I want to explain you, so I am drawing like this. Yes, children, this is a bead chain. Here each pearl is acts like a monomer. Each pearl is acts like a monomer. And this is one monomer, this is one monomer, like that. A group of monomers connected, this bond is nothing but a chemical bond. Chemical bond between each monomer. Between each monomer, understood, between each pearl considered as monomer, each monomer is connected in this pearl chain, especially that like the string. But here each monomer is connected with a chemical bonding so that they can attach with it. So it forms a long chain of polymer. That's why in fibers, mostly in nature, excuse me, Arya, 1 minute, let me complete this. 1 minute, dear, I'll give you time. Okay, so this each monomer connected with a chemical bonding in a long form of chain. So most, like whether it is natural fibers, whether it is synthetic fibers, are made up of polymers. This entire process, the connection of monomers chemically with each other to form a long chain of polymers, this process is known as polymerization. Yes, you can ask me, Arya. Arya? Yeah, you are asking me something, ma'am. Tell me.
Ma'am, like generally, how long is like one polymer?
It depends. We can say that polymerization is a continuous process. So we need to terminate. We need to terminate infinity. If we want the continuous process, we can continue it. So whenever we'll do the research work, whenever we'll do the things to initiate the chemical reaction, the scientist should know the termination of the reaction also. Understood? Only starting. Yeah. Yes, when we ride a car, we should know how to start a car and we should know how to stop the car also. Yes or no? Until we stop the car keep on traveling it.
Stop polymerization?
It will undergo some chemical process change. They'll use chemicals to terminate the reaction.
So approximately in a day, how long is the polymer?
It's infinity, I said, no? It's infinity.
Yes,
ma'am. They recur in the sense they'll keep on. Resonance will be taking place. They'll keep on terminating. One monomer is connected to other monomer continuously. The energies are continuously keep on. Have you seen the fiber thread? How it is? It's long. Until we cut into one particular bundle, we can find that the continuous thread. How much you want, you will take that and remaining you'll terminate it. At the same way, the research department like RD or A&D department will know the thing to stop, where to start and within how much time to stop. Especially radioactive elements, if we can compare with the radioactive elements, so this is the same thing will undergo there. They should know the chemicals, they should know the reagents to terminate the reaction. What do you mean by termination? To keep an end. Polymers are nothing but monomers. They are kind of monomers present in the fibers or even plastic also. So when we burn the plastic, we can see the flexibility of the plastic, no? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Why it is stretchable, children? Because of this polymers only. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Ronak, you got the answer? So no need to learn separately about the polymers. If you understand about the fibers, the same properties can be applicable to the polymers, because polymers are present inside the fibers only. You said of plastics, yes, we are going to learn about the plastics also. When we keep on going with the different properties of fibers, then we can understand about the plastics also. No need to hurry up. Let us go with the properties of different kinds of fibers, then only we can go. Any doubts? No, na? Shall I go to the next slide? Shall we move?
Yes.
Ma'am, the cotton combines together to form a thread. Then, what is the thread called then? Means the cotton.
It's a fiber. Fiber made up of polymers. No need to go for the structures. I said, na, it's chemically, it doesn't require anything to go with the structures. No. It's a simple polymer.
Okay, ma'am.
If you want to know. Yes, dear.
Mom, is it true that fibers are like hard to digest?
Yes, fibers, for example, what are the fiber, like polymer like things present in our body? Tell me. What are the polymers like things present in our body? I'm not saying they are polymers.
Oh, polymer like things.
In our body.
DNA?
Very good. Excellent, Arya. Excellent. Yes, how the strands of DNA is keep on repeating
like
it.
A bunch of chromosomes like...
Polymers, Shell. The DNA, how long is the DNA of a person, tell me? It's like infinity, it depends upon. Yeah. Each segment consists of one monomer. So they can't, if we go for the DNA test, they can't take the full DNA present in our body. Only the small part from the hair or any other part, they'll take that and they'll go for the test. Am I right? So this is the way this polymer means no need to go for the end or initiation or termination. The initiation and termination is infinity, but it consists of repeated units of monomers, same kinds of monomers. For example, we can see here beads. Is that the
Mom
beads like, are similar?
Ma'am, like is, for our DNA, like the way which you said, like how like scientists, when they're like investigating polymer, they like cut it off to a point and then they like...
They won't cut the air.
Not cut it, they would make it stop like with a chemical reaction.
DNA won't be stopped. Our body
is... Ma'am, I'm not talking about DNA. Ah. I'm talking generally about polymerization.
Yes, about polymerization, they'll use different reagents to terminate the reaction. Not only polymerization, any kind of reaction, they should know. If it is, depends upon that reaction. If it is wanted, by spontaneously, by its own, the reaction ends. But this is a kind of reaction like repeated products are forming. So in this kind of reaction, they'll add some reagents to stop the reaction. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. What about the remaining children? Ishan, Kavya, Keetana, Naisha. So whether it is natural fiber or synthetic fiber, it consists of polymers. The process known as polymerization. What are the components present inside the polymers? Monomers, which are connected chemically. Okay,